Hi guys, welcome to the next video on Linux tutorial. Today we are going to learn zip and unzip command in Linux. It is used for compressing and archiving together. Filecats, a popular pkzip and pkunzip programs, are now available as a zip and unzip on Linux and Unix systems. Zip combines the compressing function of gzip with the archive function of tar. So instead of using two commands to compress a directory structure, you can use only one, that is zip. Zip requires the first argument to be a compressed file name. The remaining arguments are interpreted as the files and directories to be compressed. We'll see how to compress the files. We have test1.html and test2.html. We'll compress these two files with the help of zip. Test.zip to give the archive name. And test1.html, test2.html. So test.zip got archived here. The unusual feature of this command is that it doesn't overwrite an existing compressed file if test.zip already exists. Files will either be updated or appended to the archive, depends on whether they are already exist in the archive or not. We'll see how it works. We'll create one more file. Now we'll try to do the same operation. Zip test.zip. This zip file is already exist. test1.html, test2.html, test3.html. It is showing updating test1.html, updating test2.html, as these two files were already exist in the test.zip, and test3.html got added to the test.zip. You can see test.zip got created. Now we'll see the next option, that is recursive compression. For recursive behavior, zip uses hyphen r option. It descends the tree structure in the same way tar does, except that it also compresses files. Now we can easily compress our home directory. Now we are into the home. We'll clear the screen. We are into the home. Now we want to compress whole directory. CD means home directory. Now we are into the home directory, comma, test.zip hyphen r. Zip hyphen r test.zip space dot. It means current directory. It will zip entire home directory content. Now clear the screen. You can see test.zip got created. We'll see how unzip works. Files are restored with unzip command, which in its simplest form uses the compressed file name as an argument. Unzip does a non-interactive restoration if it doesn't overwrite any existing files. We'll see how it works. As of now, we'll remove these three files. Now we have only test.zip. We want to do unzip of this file. Now this test.zip got unzipped. This is a non-interactive way of unzipping. Now we'll see the interactive way. As these three files are present in this directory, unzip of this test.zip should result in permission from the user. Now we'll try to do the similar operation. Unzip test.zip. So it will ask replace test1.html. We can give yes, no, all, or rename. Yes, yes. Now these got unzipped. Replaced. It means replaced. Now we'll see the next option, that is viewing archive, that is with the help of hyphen v option. You can view the compressed archive with the hyphen v option. The list shows both the compressed and uncompressed size of each file in the archive, along with the percentage of compression achieved. Now we have test.zip. We can use unzip hyphen v test.zip. So it will show the length, method, size, how much compression rate got achieved, time, and the name of the file. As of now, we are done with zip and unzip. Thank you, guys.